Hello.
And welcome back to another episode of Dragon Quest Builders, aka Pippa and Friends, aka Winky and Friends, aka whatever you want to call it.
So when we last left off, we were wondering, where do we get Coralie's and Daffodaisies?
We got them by killing the... are they called Drakies or Drokies?
Drakies, Zubats.
Golbats.
These guys.
Golbats.
Drop those, and then I also went on the scavenging needed to finish the steel stockade, because that would have been a very boring 10 minutes of video.
Yeah.
Well, so I'm not done. I want to wait and finish it as part of this. So, oops, I should do that. What should you do first?
Finish the Hammerton Hot Harden.
A hot house?
Hot house. Not Heart Harden.
That sounds like a place I would not want to go.
It sounds like a place where you attempt to freeze water by heating it.
Hey, for the grassy
garden.
And that's
a place?
Apparently. I discovered a new recipe for it. Yes. And then we need to...
Well, Taylor knows destroyed once we finish the building. Get the Daffodaisy Bud, find the, Coralie. Nice.
I need my handy dandy
shovel.
And then I need
to get the buds out of your inventory. They're in the other page.
Oh no, not plumber. Oh, there.
Yeah, they're in the other side.
There we
see
are.
Them? Yeah, there they are. Coralie. Such a beautiful name.
That was the wrong button. Okay, let's finish this up. So I will assume the other Daffodaisy goes in that spot. And the corner goes here. Voila! Magic.
Should we use the grassy seed we got while trying to get the Coralies in this room? Huh? Botanical Garden.
Botanical Garden.
Increases automatic HP recovery by 1.
Well, I'm in...
Also makes for a very nice intro room.
Yes. Oh, whoa.
Wow, everybody likes the, place.
All the things I've done, this has gotten the biggest reaction of all. Okay.
I don't slang every
And then roll back. Goes right back to building a steel stockade. Building a steel stockade.
So just place them in the set of doors once you get the thing correct. No. There you go.
And
place down the evil eye doll.
Now what I did learn the hard way. You're facing this way and you can't face it that way if the walls and the doors are... Fine.
Happy.
So, those have to go down before the wall goes down, and then magic.
This is gonna get less attention. Better people are going to step along the way. Along the way. Oh, nobody's going to come celebrate it.
Nope. Oh,
Rolo. Except for Rolo. He thinks you're cool.
He's gonna get burned alive.
He's immune.
I want to do some things with the walls first. I need bricks. I'm gonna make more bricks. Did I make those bricks?
Make what bricks? For what?
The stone walls. I think I did.
Aha. Are you going to put them around the edges so that they can't get in?
Yes. So I want this to be the place they think is the fastest way in. That's sort of already that way. That'll work. All right, where's Rolo? You see me Rolo-in. Where is he? Oh, he's in my teleportarium.
Twin teleportarium.
By my bold and beautiful brow, you've completed the steel stockade. Now our city is safe from any attack. 3 cheers for Winky. Hip, hip.
Stop.
What? Is the stockade truly strong enough to keep the golem at bay? Don't you remember, Winky? The golem was at our side. It watched over the people of Cantlin and protected them from harm. I don't know what LaRouche is trying to convince you of, but there is no way that golem would ever harm us. Besides, it's unthinkable that the creature who once served mankind will become the leader of the monster's forces.
You do realize he can hear you, right?
Oh, yeah.
He's literally floating in midair listening to this entire conversation.
He's magic. Uh-oh, now I've gone too close. All right, we're going to have to watch. Whoa. It rolls a bit of a close talker. There is simply no basis for this silly story of his. He's done nothing but stirring up unrest. It's people like LaRouche who hold back a city's progress, you know. We might have to do something about him.
What, do you want to kill him?
Hey. But anyway, good work, Winky. Our new defenses are second to none. Wah-ha-ha-ha-ha. Seed of life. Yay. Teleportarium. Okay, I need to zoom out. I need to zoom out. There we go. Okay, now I can. Oh. The newest quest. Oh.
Here likes the teleportarium.
Winky, my boy, our city is growing by the day. Some sort of decisive battle with the monsters must be brewing, don't you think? Now that we've finished constructing the steel stockade, our defenses are nigh impregnable.
What is that?
What are they? Can't be broken, penetrated, or entered into. I must say, I'm not quite satisfied. Our fortifications could be a great deal stronger than they are now. Which brings me to my request. I think it's time you put a little bit more work into this city.
Let me guess, level it up.
A few new rooms will be a sorely overdue addition to our town, my boy. We could also do with overhauling our defenses to better fend off the monster's increasingly fierce assaults. I won't bore you with the particulars, you're the builder after all. Just improve our town however you see fit.
Why don't you make that place a room? You know, the one with the colossal coffer in it. You just need a bit of dirt. You could also make some of those straw floorings and place them in rooms.
You really want straw flooring, don't you?
Yeah.
Do I even have straw? Do I have enough?
Check.
Go to the crafting table. I don't need straw. I need this stuff. Maybe.
Well.
How about I?
Well, how about you place the grass seed?
Remember, I made private rooms for everybody in another. Oh, there's an empty room. Make a private room out of that.
Who are you gonna give it to?
I don't know.
Yourself?
This is annoying. I made this one my room.
Well, it has enough room for a lot of people. Maybe you could separate it into two separate
Oops.
Rooms. Isn't it great, Inky? Our city just keeps growing and growing. Our new friend Magnus seems like a really reliable fellow. He might not have any hair, but he's got a really lovely beard.
He's got a beard thing.
I was thinking of making him some clothes, but do you think he'd wear them? Maybe you should ask him, Winky.
That's too funny. I forgot what I'm doing. Oh, let me. Oh,
you saying that was more funnier than her actual sentence.
Let's see. A gentleman's. Because I'm a gentleman.
Yeah, killing monsters daily. You're definitely a gentleman.
Gentleman, not gentleman.
Gentlemen. Many gentlemen. You could turn it, you could wall off the area and give it to somebody else and just add another door.
Nope. Oh, my own room.
But, what you can do is,
Yeah, I know. I know what you're saying.
And some monsters appear.
You say near Winky's room or near Winky's village? Oh. Haha. That turned out rather well. Any more?
Of course, you could burn yourself.
Well. I got room over here.
Hmm. gold box.
I have a super hammer.
I think I can make a better one. Although, I don't know. I already put this. Are you just going to make like a really long line of private bedrooms or something?
I don't know what I'm gonna do. Can I say I can make an inn? Can I make an inn sign?
I think you can.
But I don't know what goes in an inn.
You need dirt.
I ran out of dirt.
That's
not
even
really possible. Didn't mean to do that.
You don't have to make the room very big. You can make it tiny. You don't have to make it that big.
I'm not gonna make the one room. Oh, maybe do you do that like the
door? Wait, you're going to make that the entire room?
Never mind.
Like, you could make it. Like, what you could do is, I'll like, you could separate. You could make it like a tiny hallway and just, like, put a ton of doors everywhere.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I can make. Alright, I need dirt, though.
I'm already seeing it.
In your mind's eye.
Yes.
Spin slice. Never would have learned that if it weren't for LaRouche.
Yes. Aren't we going out to slay dragons, though? Maybe. Didn't I say that we were going out to slay dragons in this episode?
I can't slay dragons. I said I'm gonna wait till I can build those bomb things and blow them up.
Alright.
I can make three tiny bedrooms, can't I?
Well, what you could do
all right,
is...
Hang on. Come on. Hold up. Let's...
Yeah, that's what I was thinking you could do.
Just make two?
Well, I didn't think about it. Well, maybe if you made that one a little thinner... Like, if you made that wall one block, like, if you broke the leading block right there, and then you spread it across, and you made the door on the very edge, you could fit a third room.
I probably don't even need it. Perfect. Although, one of the challenges is making a room level, making your village level 5. Although, I build more stuff later, I think. How about I'm just gonna make two rooms.
I'm sorry if this is boring. I'm not sure if I'm even close enough.
Yeah. Whatever. Don't need to be Frank Lloyd Wright here. I just need to make. Oops. Kind of derpy. I need pots and doors and beds, right?
Yeah.
Let's see if I need something useful. Hey, your favorite.
Stuff floor. Why'd they make so many ladders? And what's the thing above where you're hiding? I mean, where your thing is. I guess it would be Winky's hand? Like, what's that thing that looks like it has salt in it?
What the?
A bathtub! It said that you're just getting all wrinkly.
Let's see. I already have beds. Ooh, a king size bed.
You should put that in your room.
And a regular bed.
You should put the king size in
your room. Can I make a regular bedroom with a king? I don't need two mattresses for a normal bedroom, right?
Yes. Or just place it in your private bedroom.
I think I want a private bedroom. Alright, nap time. And we'll level up our humble abode.
I always like that music.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Well, I was thinking that you could build a dirt wall next to that and just place another door, and then you can make like a private bedroom for somebody.
Yeah.
Maybe Pippa.
Pippa has a private bedroom.
Alright, she does.
These two are gonna sleep a bit more in line. Lights.
That's too close to the entrance.
Doors.
But you have that one bed where the door should be.
It'll be fine. Some grass. Right, and broken branches. I had enough broken branches to make two basic doors. What's up, Kenlin? Oh, I need pots, don't I?
Yes.
Do I have any of my equipment? I have one. And one more pot. And I have torches. Yay. So I just need one more pot. Okay.
You should put the king size bed in your room.
Can I? In my room, you mean?
Yeah.
I really want a king size bed in my room, don't you? Okay, do that. Alright. Chest in the room too.
No, you need a
pot.
No, apparently you don't. You need to move that bed.
Why?
Well, because it's where the door should be.
What door?
Oh wait.
What are you talking about?
Oh, I thought you were going to like.
Ugh. Actually, there's a whole bunch of decorations that I can put down to make there's my king size
bed. Nice.
That was worth more than a basic bedroom. Worth it.
I like his little dance.
Come on, Rollo.
Doesn't care.
By my flaring nostrils, marvelous work, Winky. Our city is growing ever greater, and so are you. Oh, boy. Now listen closely, my boy. I have big news. With the Kenton Chronicle, I have found a description of the biggest and boldest defensive structure ever invented. It's called the Kentland Shield, and if that isn't a majestic and awe-inspiring name, I don't know what is. If we had one of those, we could protect our home against anything. It even goes so far as to say we could consider the reconstruction of Kentland complete. However, while the Kentland Chronicle describes the shield's function and appearance, the details of how to build it are sadly lacking. As it stands, we simply won't be able to make the thing. But there is still hope. I can offer you a few clues as to its construction, but they're sure to stir some ingenious ideas in that builder's brain of yours. I know that one day you will unravel the secret of how to build a Kentland Shield. No pressure, Winky. By my straining shoulders, Twinkie, the monsters are preparing another descent. Yeah. As I suspected, they see a town growing ever greater and become more daring and desperate in their attempts to stop it. However, we're not yet ready to take on the leader. We must drive these monsters back to buy some more time. Winky, my boy, are you ready for combat?
Sure. Oh, you know what I forgot to build?
What?
Oh, never mind. Oops, what happened?
What are you doing? Wrong edge.
That didn't go as planned.
You attracted them to the wrong side.
Holy Toledo.
Oh, he's running straight into the wall.
Ugh, destroyed my tower. That didn't go as planned. I had the wrong weapon on hand.
Sword doesn't do more damage.
Pretty sure the hammer's still on.
I'm not sure if just whacking his butt is gonna do much.
Like spanking him.
Bad boy!
Well, that was basically
uneventful.
Worthless construction. Hey! Teleporter pie!
And I think I'm finally going to get a new character to make a voice for.
That's right.
Oh yeah! There you go.
Oh yeah, hang on.
We finally have a person to voice, right, besides Pippa.
Before we all start congratulating each other on how awesome they are, I have to recover from this disaster. Oh, you know why? It's made out of dirt. Oops. I cannot for the life remember how this thing goes. This way. Is that rebuilt now? I need some stone cladding. Oops. Where's it missing from? That one went? Can't be right.
Never said the thing was destroyed.
Wait, not the stone stockade.
Steel stockade.
I gotta place those down. Okay.
I noticed that the thing was broken, so...
I guess not. Is that what it looks like?
I think so.
Alright, it's intact. Okay. Now, what else? Oh, I gotta... Did this get rebuilt? Oh, you know what? I'm gonna make some stone cladding.
Aren't you gonna talk to the world?
Oh yeah, let me fix this. Otherwise I'll forget and I'll never do it.
I don't know any accents or different voices or anything. What am I supposed to do?
Try and sound more like... a dirty blonde.
I don't even know what they sound like. I'm guessing like normal people, but...
Probably. Is my cladding? Yay.
That might have been a bit defensive to some people.
This stuff is awesome. Oh, that's right. This whole room got destructed.
Destructed? It's not even a room. I think you are allowed to make the bombs now. The dude's about to give you the code. Code.
How'd that help me level up my...
Maybe you should only do the front side. It's like they're going to be attacking from the other side that often.
I know. I just wanted to get it so it was ready. Okay. I'm going to bed. I'll wake up. Sleep in my...
Your new king-size bed.
And then we'll talk and then we'll finish up?
How's Very royal. She's just been standing there all night waiting for you to introduce yourself to her.
Maybe she's been hovering over me like...
Her name.
Oh, should I talk to the Magnus first? No, okay, we'll introduce ourselves.
Oh my! What is this wonderful place? It's so bright and warm! Well, expecting that cold look on your face, young man. Or perhaps not. Your face might be cold, but I can see the fire in your eyes. You want to know what I'm doing here this late in the day, don't you? There's no point trying to deny it. I can read you like an open book. This place looks like the perfect city full of buildings and people and lights. But the truth is, whoever lives here seems awfully anxious. Personally, the only thing I feel is exhausted from walking all the way here. I hope you don't mind if I join you. My name's Chera. I don't have any particular talents, but I'm a dab hand at being one of the world.
You want to call her Chera or Sherry?
Sherry. Okay. I misread it.
Just checking.
Sherry.
And then we'll talk to... Oh, it's not Magnus.
It's Sheridan.
Did I make a voice for Sheridan? Has he said anything yet?
He has to have, because you introduced yourself to him, right? Well, what do you think it would sound like? Like, I tried to make Sherry sound kind of mischievous because I know she has kind of a funny line
at some point. I got kind of a dark, low, dopey voice for Canal. Magnus is...
I think he would have kind of an upbeat voice. He looks kind of, like, upbeat and cheerful.
Very boyish.
Looks like that.
Wow, Winky, you did an incredible job stopping all those monsters. And not only that, you found the new teleportal too. Remarkable. Oh, and by the way, LaRouche told me what happened. It was the golem who crushed Catlett into dust. If that's the case, then there's no doubt about it. The monster that rules over these lands is the same golem that guarded Catlett. Winky, do you know what this means? I can help. I can finally help. After all my years of wandering, I finally found a place where I could be of use. Once, during my travels, I met an inventor who taught me how to build things called wrecking balls.
I came in like a wrecking...
A little too loud, you're gonna blow up people's speakers. If the golem would attack us, something as powerful as a wrecking ball would absolutely invaluable. Would be. Let me teach you how to make them. I've never been able to build them myself, so I can't wait to see if they work.
You do this and you dat and you do motions with your hands.
Thought he dabbed too. And the souls and steel sphere. Okay. That's it. And looks like Sherry got dressed. Yay, Sherry. Alright, that was kind of anticlimactic. Anyway, we built lots of stuff. We defended our castle, or Cantlin, and we now know how to make wrecking balls. A good day.
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
Go to your bench.
Oh, yes. Let's go to the goodbye bench.
The goodbye and good morning.
Oops.
Bench.
No.
Hi.
No. Oh. Rock. Oh, I am. There's a ravine over there that's full of rock bombs. If you defeat them quickly enough, you'll be able to collect their shards.
Oh, yeah, those things that are really annoying to kill because they blow up.
We'll need those wrecking balls if we're going to stand a chance of defeating the golem. I thought he was just going to repeat himself. Get away from me. Thanks for watching. Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
We'll see you next time in our botanical garden.
As Magnus and Rollo...
I really like this garden. It's like a peaceful
Stop
place.
Stop covering our beautiful face.
And now it was my own private little garden, and now everybody's real time. All right. Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Bye.